it's Division 4 time. We've just had round 14 moving into round 15. I'm Tommy Javor.
I'm Shaun DIFF Jacobsen.
And I'm Darcy Evans.
And we're from various places. All right, let's start with the results straight away. It was an interesting set of results. I think we all got 4 out of 5. I certainly did.
Yeah.
Don't anyone try and tell me you picked 5 out of 5, because that was a big upset. Get to, but we'll start with Eastern Park 18-7 115, Salisbury 15-10 100. This one was at Eastern Park, that's why we tipped Eastern Park. It was Williamson was the star with 6, Woodward chimed in along with Rayleigh with 3, as did McMullen. McMullen, Knapp and Williamson were the best for them, whilst for Salisbury, Borges continues his consistent season with Catford and Bennett, and Borges, I mean, what a fantastic effort, 8 goals on a losing team.
Fantastic win there, so that puts them equal second now. Eastern Park.
Yep.
So very good wins.
They needed that one to keep up with Salisbury, and they've got it.
They've got 10 wins apiece with Salisbury, so well done to Eastern Park. It's been a trip there, so, but indeed.
And top four, interesting as well.
Very tight at the top, Schneisen tight. My old German girlfriend. Okay, Kenilworth, 14-11, 95. Hectorville, 14-10, 94. Hectorville, they're starting to improve. This one was at home, but just a 1-point win there to Kenilworth. And we'll just quickly, Chesser, Friend and Moser all kicked 3 for Kenilworth. Gain, Moser and Crowell were their stars. Broadbent kicked 5 for Hectorville, whilst Broadbent, Watton and Fincher were the standouts. And just looking at it, mate, it's a 1-point game, but really Kenilworth controlled it all day, didn't they?
They did, but that 1 point, seriously, they could have been 1 point away from, but if you look at equal with Hectorville being relegated, so that 2 games clear now of Hectorville, so that puts them in a bit of breathing space.
Actually, and I hate to do this to you, 2.5 games.
I know, that bloody, it's killing me. That draw kills me and it gets me. I'm supposed to be the technical expertise on this, but now it's got me again.
Yeah, and that's probably why some people watch this show, just to see you forget about the draw.
And mess up.
To actually get some of the insight into the games, I mean, they're 33 points up at three-quarter time away from home, Kenilworth. So Hectorville came with the thunder, kicking 7-3 to 2-1, but didn't quite get the chocolates.
That was shattered Hectorville to pieces at 1 point.
Yeah, and that will probably, that's it's official, isn't it?
Yeah, they get the more next year.
Your DIFF has just sent you to DIFF 5.
Yeah, gone.
All right. And what was a pretty one-sided affair was Westminster Old Scholars 16-17, 113. Hope Valley 11-11, 77. Newman kicked 5 with Woods and Blytham both kicking 3 for Westminster. Whilst for Hope Valley, Mitchell continues his fantastic season with 5 goals. Better players for Westminster with Easton, Newman and Reed. Whilst for Hope Valley, Michael Stevens, the coach, is giving himself best. Why not? Mitchell and Bonmore, I used to do it regularly, mate. Well, back in the days of the mugs. And as we said, DIFF, this one really was a little bit more one side than what the paper tells us, wasn't it?
Yeah, I thought it was going to be a real tight one this game, but yeah, Westminster far too good out there.
Yeah.
And Matty Newman, geez, he's been there for a few years now, and as you said, doesn't get better with age, it seems.
No, we all tipped it, but I mean, I'm a bit surprised to see 30 scoring shots to 10 at three quarter time, 14-16 to 7-3. Obviously, a fair bit of fight shown in the last quarter there from Hope Valley, but not really getting within
a little more. Too late.
Yeah.
And we said about the top four, but Westminster's win, that puts them 1 game clear now in the first spot, so that's a good breathing space then as well. Just so Parraka. Probably Hope Valley, probably slight chance with 5, but to leave Westminster 1 game clear now with coming into a few.
Funny you should mention that, Two Dogs, because Parraka you would have thought were a real chance for the 5, but they met a very efficient team by the name of Glenunga, who had their second win of the year, so well done to the boys at Glenunga. And it was Glenunga, 21 goals, 6, 132, Parraka 10-12, 72, and they controlled the game, 5 goals up at quarter time, and managed to maintain a 4 goal buffer, and an 11 goal, what a third quarter, 8 goals, 2 to 1 goal, 3. To tell you what, the Glenunga boys would have been a real happy
cock-a-hoo.
Yeah, absolutely. Just quickly, Parraka, better goal kickers, Vandermeer kicked 4, Ivan Dydak kicked 3, Pete and Baker were their better players, but Glenunga, is that B. Ellis? That's not Brett Ellis, is it?
Oh, I've got no idea.
Brant Ellis, not the Ellis we know. Kick 7, so you're now my new favourite Ellis. Mark Roberts kicking 6, Bennett kicking 2 with Abel. Ellis was best with Nichols and Roberts. And I tell you what, there was one that was a mouth-watering prospect. It was our game of the round, and it was North Haven taking on Kilburn.
Chicks.
The Chicka Chick Train. It was North Haven 13-4, 92. Kilburn 11-16, 82. North Haven again, they held the lead at every change and managed to win comfortably enough, I guess. It got a bit closer than they probably would have wanted. Reed back into goal kickers finally with a bit of vengeance with four. Matt also kicked four. That's Colin Matt, your mate, isn't it?
Yeah, that's old Matt. It's good to see he's getting through games, not belting people.
Yes, yes. It's good to see when he kicks more goals than games reported. So Colby kicked three. Merritt Dickinson and Rory Durden were best for North Haven. Whilst for Kilburn, there was a pretty good spread. Braxton kicked two with Cez McCammon, I'm not sure if that's right, and old boy Gravel Dick, Sandercock kicked two, while Vinnie Ubranik, O'Loughlin and Galbraith were the best for Kilburn. And that one, boys, I tell you what, I tipped it, so I guess I say I can't be too surprised by it, but...
well done for Kilburn, they 10 points to the top side, that sort of gives a bit of confidence too, going into the finals as well, so...
Yeah, I think Kilburn would have really fancied their chances in that one, so...
Yeah. I'd be glad that they've... managed to win one after losing three on the trot as well.
Yeah, and that win, it just changes everything, doesn't it? Because it puts them right back on top of the thing, as you've already mentioned, mate. Let's get into leading goal kickers with the analyst.
I like that one. I've got a few comments about that one as well. So,
hello.
A few comments around the place. So, Matthew Reed from North Haven on 77, leading the way by about 9 goals to Darren Mitchell from Hope Valley. Morris Freeman from Eastern Park on 49. Brad Borges from Soldier on 48 and Ian Williamson from Eastern Park on 32. So Matthew Reed still leading the way by a good margin.
Yes, and I know you went here for 6 or 5, DIFF 6 or 5, but what's it called again, I ask you?
Last time they met DIFF.
Last time they met DIFF is back by popular demand. Just keep getting the name of it.
Good
Yeah, I came with that. Just took, it cost me $2.70 a week to come up with that as well. Alright, so our first one is Kilburn versus Westminster. What's the ladder tell us, Darcy?
Kilburn, they're in fourth, Westminster in fifth, so look, they're about 3 games separating. So Kilburn with 10 wins, no draws, and Westminster 7 wins, but I think still Kilburn out there.
Yeah, Westminster need to win. I guess I'm pretty curious as to what happened last time.
Last time they happened with Kilburn 15-10, 100, defeated Westminster 11-10, 76.
And that one was at, of course, Glendale or Westminster or wherever they were playing that game. I believe it's Glendale. Look, Kilburn, I think, too strong for me. It's good to see some familiar names popping up. We've mentioned them, Ubranik, you've got your Galbraith, Cutlush Williams, Shrekie Graham. This could be his 200 this week, is it? It is his 200th game.
Congratulations.
So congratulations to Andrew Shrek Graham. When you're on the piss and you're building someone, give AG Criminal Law a call. Your man, the Shrek, will look after you and he will charge you a very small fee. Mention this show and get 2.5% off.
Does he ever represent himself?
Boys, tips, I've been on Kilburn.
Kilburn.
Kilburn, easy.
Two. And good luck to the Shrekie. North Haven, they're sitting back on top, aren't they, Darcy?
Back on top. And they're clear of Salisbury.
And they're back at home taking on bottom place Wollongong, who are on their best winning streak of the year. But a good one.
North Haven at home, very, very hard to beat. There'll be a big margin here, I think.
Yeah, I think they could come back to earth a little bit Wollongong this week. They've got to try and stop Reed, Matt, and Durden. Tommy Lipson's voice from the side, it's just too much.
Oh, yeah, no, North Haven will, yes, make Wollongong this week, I reckon, yeah. 15 plus goals, easy win for the boys out there.
Wouldn't be the first thing smoked at North Haven, would it?
Nah, definitely not. Won't be the last ever.
Great club, though. I was down there this year. A lovely club. So, and we just got to go on. Paraka come back to Lindblom Park and they're going to have to face some angry natives after last week's display. They'll be visited by Eastern Park. They've had a pretty good rivalry over the years, Darcy, positions on the ladder.
Yeah, Eastern Park are third, Prac are sixth. They would have been equal fifth if it wasn't for that loss against Wollongong last week. So that's put them one game behind in fifth. So you'd think, I think Eastern Park still very. Eastern Park are very good at the moment. Sitting third, 10 wins, equal second Salisbury. And Prac had that loss last week against Wollongong. Yeah. Gee whiz, we haven't done much of their confidence there either.
I didn't do it last game because I thought it was going to be one-sided, but it's better tell us what happened last time.
Eastern Park 21-12, 138 defeated Prac, 13-13 at 91. I reckon the margin will be about the same again this week.
One-sided enough to suggest where the ladder and the positions. Logic tells me Eastern Park would be too strong. Williamson's starting to hit top form now. And there's plenty of support for him flying around as well. So we are all on the Parkers, aren't we?
Yeah.
Kenilworth and Hope Valley. This one is at St Mary's Park. And this is a pretty big one because you'd think that these two teams are safe. But just to make sure they're safe and for one last crack at finals, they need to basically win their last four games. One of them's going to win this week.
So indeed, TJ, 7th and 8th. So just really one game has been nice. If they do lose and Hectorville just happen to get a couple of them without Hectorville or Kenilworth winning anymore, you never know, but seriously, I think they're in. But
how far out the five are they?
At the five, they're only two games, actually.
How far out there?
One and a half. He is sitting up for another cracker.
What happened last time they met you?
Well, this was the draw game.
What's that? No!
This was Hope Valley. It was Hope Valley, 16-13-109. Kenilworth, 15-19-109. So this was the draw game, this one. So
that's the one that gets me every time.
Yeah, it's been a war game. There it is. Hope Valley, Steve, like we said, best last week. They've got some good forwards in Mitchell, and they've Duggan's floating around down there. But Kenilworth, Chesser, Friend, Moser starting to play better footy, and I think Kenilworth at home will be too strong.
Correct.
Yep, I reckon Kenilworth by about 4 goals.
It's a massive over that one. They're used to training on it.
Without Paul Manuel here, no one's disagreeing with me. It's quite odd. last one, Hectorville, they've had a better month. They really have. They've been a lot more consistent at home and away, but heading to Salisbury. Salisbury coming off a loss. They're sitting in second, aren't they, Darcy?
They are sitting second.
And Hector second to bottom, yeah.
So you still think Hector. Oh, they have a good week. They have had a couple of good weeks, and with 3 wins now, but certainly Salisbury by another big mark.
Yeah, Hordes to probably have a bit of a day out, being very good up forward this year. The McPherson boys are also very solid. I can't see Salisbury Magpies dropping this one.
Yeah, Salisbury. The bite's been taken out of Hectorville. Now they know they're getting relegated, so yeah, Salisbury, I reckon, will do this quite easy.
Well, mathematically they're not relegated, but I think I know what you're saying, mate.
Yeah.
It's been the Division 4 weekly roundup. Thanks for watching.
See you later.
See ya.